Therefore,
I have
what Bible says I have.
I am
what Bible says I am.
I can do
what Bible says I can do.
I present my body
as holy and living sacrifice.
Lord Jesus has given me
spirit of power, love, and sound mind.
I cannot be confused.
I cannot be defeated.
I have the mind of Christ.
Jesus has made me holy and righteous.
I am dead to sin, alive to God.
There is no condemnation in me
because I am forgiven.
I have eternal and abundant life in Christ Jesus.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Let us give biggest offering to the one who deserves it.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It's good to be back after a break of one Sunday. And I tell you, the one who did minister the word last Sunday, they did complete justice to what they did. The best part of Kenny's declaration, praise God, and the word were amazing. I have watched this service at least 3 times again. Praise God for that. Thank you, Jesus. Shalom, blessings, greetings. And as we are entering a new season, a different season, a more festive season, I'm going to just draw your attention to a few new things. Hallelujah, praise God. But even before I launch into that sermon, I want you to open one chapter, and that is Matthew chapter 12. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew chapter 12, praise God. And let's read one particular verse, verse number 5 and verse number 6. See, it's good to have red letter Bible because I love that because it highlights everything what Jesus ever spoke. And we better pay attention to when Jesus speaks, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. And Jesus made certain claims as well. And some of the claims we know very well. Some of the claims we don't pay attention to that much. We're going to talk about one of the claim right now. Hallelujah. So if you have Matthew chapter 12, verse number 5 and verse number 6.
Hallelujah, praise God. Jesus is saying, Mandir karta, ahin ek moto che. Hallelujah. My English Bible says, there is one who is greater than temple. Amen, praise God. In Hebrews chapter 12, Jesus made 3 statements, greater than. Hallelujah, praise God. Even though he is greatest, he wanted to draw the attention, ke what you are thinking, I am somebody greater than that. Praise God. For them, temple was pretty big deal. Temple's ritual was pretty big deal. Whatever they do in temple was pretty big deal. But when Jesus stands there, he says, I am greater than temple. Praise God. 2 more greater than temple statement comes in the same chapter. I want you to go home and read it. He says, greater than Jonah is here. And he also said, there is a greater than Solomon is here as well. Praise God. We will talk about that some other time. Hallelujah. Praise God. But what I want to tell you, hallelujah. Praise God. Okay, a lot of time we tend to focus on things, not Jesus. We also tend to focus on things that point to Jesus, but not to Jesus. Isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bible teaches us, as we read and study the Bible, Bible teaches us that every book from the Bible is revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. In a simple word, I can tell you, it's all about Jesus. It's all about Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And ghani badi baat aayi hai sir, ke when we start looking at different things, hallelujah, that causes distractions. Right? Jesus goes on a back burner and that thing becomes more important. The ritual becomes more important. How we dress becomes more important. How we stand becomes more important. How we cover our heads becomes more important. Where we put our shoes becomes more important. The constitution becomes more important. Hallelujah, praise God. When Jesus said, there is greater than temple here, I want to tell you, all of things we could think or imagine, there is one greater, and that is Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. It is all about Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. When Jesus says there is one greater than temple here, what is a temple? Temple is the presence of God. Temple is the place where man meet God. Temple is the presence where the glory of God
is dwelling, isn't it? Praise God. Be with me, be with me. I wanted to draw this, get this thought before I move ahead and launch into the sermon. This is not my sermon. This is just a prep work. Hallelujah, praise God. Temple is the presence of God. Temple is a place where God, man meet God. And temple is where the glory of God resides. When Jesus says, there is one greater than temple, he's saying, presence of God is there in the temple, but the greater presence is in Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You can meet God in temple, but if you meet me, you can meet God in a greater way. Amen. Hallelujah. The glory of God is there, but the highest and the most powerful and the most amount of all glory. Bible says, keo mahima jo bapna ekaki janit dikrana mahima jeo mahima. Apne enama dito. The glory of God revealed, indwelled in Lord Jesus Christ is the highest. And that is why he can say, hallelujah, the one greater than temple is here. Praise God. Praise God for churches. Praise God for ministry. Praise God for things we do. Praise God for everything. But hallelujah, my focus, my purpose, hallelujah, to point to Jesus right now. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. When we study this, what happens? My entire focus is one thing, that we will know more about Jesus. Or let me put it the other way. We will know Jesus more. Hallelujah, praise God. It is amazing, and it is so different with Jesus. Praise God. Not with you guys, but usually you guys. If you don't know people more, then you like them more. Jyaan sudhi tame loko ne pure pura odakta nathi, tyaan sudhi you like them. Par dhare dhare ghada gun badha khabar padva mande, then you can figure it out. Oh, the things are not exactly the way it looks outside, isn't it? So a lot of time in human realm, when you need know a person more, your love and your affection become sometimes questionable. But I want to tell you, that's not with Jesus. You may have been disappointed with people when you know them more. I am telling you, if you know Jesus more, you will not be disappointed. You will love him more. You will follow him more. You will worship him more. You will praise him more. And you will follow after him more. Praise God. If I can achieve just one thing and one thing alone in the whole 2019 to grow you one step closer to know Jesus and love Jesus more, I have done my job. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So the sermon series that we're going to start, and it's going to go all the way towards Christmas time. The name of the sermon series that I want to name it, Greater Than Temple. Amen. Everybody say Greater Than Temple. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is very important for us, hallelujah, especially those who are coming. We all come from mother churches, and I'm not pointing fingers at all, isn't it? Praise God. But I'm saying a lot of time we are focused on so many things other than Lord Jesus Christ. When Jesus stands in the temple and says, boys, I'm greater than all of this. Hallelujah. All the rituals you're doing, I'm greater than that. All the sacrifices you're following, I'm greater than that. All the customs that you're keeping, I'm greater than that. Hallelujah. Praise God. So we need to understand why Jesus is greater than the temple. Praise God. Hallelujah. My Bible teaches me, as I said, the Bible is the revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Bible is not a book to go how to live life well. I'm just saying that, okay? This is not ke khali apne apnu jeevan kevi te jeevu che. No. It is not about that. It is about Lord Jesus Christ. And when he look at Jesus, when Jesus looks at you, when you are transformed by Jesus, then Jesus can change the way you live. Jesus can change the way you and I live, isn't it? Praise God. Yes, we will get so many answers from it, but one thing and one thing is for sure, we will find Jesus when you open this book. Hallelujah. John chapter 1, 1 said, we all know that. Hallelujah. Praise. In the beginning was the word was God, the word was with God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And that is Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. So my focus is, we're going to take 6 or 7 sermon series, Greater Than Temple. And today's message is almost like an introductory message to that. Hallelujah. To the sermon series, praise God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God, hallelujah. When Israelites were brought out from the slavery of Egypt, which is symbolic of you and I coming out of the slavery of sin, the moment they were brought out, did you notice
God did not give them any law in Egypt. God did not teach them how to worship in Egypt. God did not tell them how to honor him, how to go in the presence in Egypt. When they were brought out of Egypt, then God revealed to them how you can worship me and come into my presence. Hallelujah. Praise God. In sin, we can only try. Hallelujah. Praise God. When we are living a life of disobedience and rebellion, we can only try, but we will never come close to what God has ordained for us. But when we are born again, then God reveals that how to love him, how to worship him, how to exalt him, and how to walk in that relationship with him. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. So when Jesus, God brought them out from the Egypt bondage, and God designed this whole idea of tabernacle. Hallelujah. Praise God. But even the idea of tabernacle, God gave them very minute instructions. Where to camp? How to camp? I'm saying, like, praise God, Brampton is expanding so much and they have trouble how to provide all the resources to Brampton. Isn't it? Praise God. There were 6 million men were living in that wilderness day in and day night, and God had a perfect plan for them. Yeah. Hallelujah. Gandhinagar was not the first planned city. This tabernacle and this campsite was a planned city. Isn't it? It was perfectly planned. Hallelujah. Praise God. The 12 tribes, where do they have to live? Where do they have to camp? When they have to camp? When they have to finish the camp and start walking? It was all given by God. And when God gives something, we better pay attention to it, because there is a greater meaning behind what God gives. Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Even in the trivial things, which you find it is trivial, but they are not trivial, there's a greater meaning behind it. Nani vastuma prabhunu motu revelation pragatthaicha. And we better pay attention to those things. Hallelujah, praise God. The first thing I want to tell you, how did they camp? Hallelujah, praise God. They camped around the tabernacle. Isn't it? You know, tabernacle area ma to and a camp alag area ma to. Church Maninagar ma to, bada city ma to. No, nothing was like that. Everybody camped around tabernacle. So if you see the whole nation of Israel, what was in the center of them? Tabernacle. Hallelujah, praise God. The center was tabernacle. The center was presence of God. The center, hallelujah, was the place to commune with God and talk with God. Hallelujah. I pray and believe that even in your life and my life, hallelujah, Jesus doesn't sit on the left corner or doesn't sit on a right corner. He sits right in the center of your life and my life. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want to show how they were camped. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. This is just a map of how they were camping. Hallelujah. As I told you, Bible is a revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Even if you see the map, how they are camping, what do you see there? You see a cross, isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. It is all about Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. In the church, sometimes it's about me. No. But nothing about you and me. It is about
Jesus.
Him and him alone, isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. Even when God gives a minute direction of how to camp, you can see the plan of God. You can see the purpose of God. You can see the will of God for you and me. And the will of God and you for you and me is to receive the salvation through the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. Where Jesus hung. Hallelujah. Died. Hallelujah. Buried and resurrection. Hallelujah. For you and me. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. So even this thing, how the tribes were located. Hallelujah. Praise God. It reveals plan and purpose of God. Sometimes we think, like, avadu sikhvani su jaruri chhe apde. Isn't it? Why do we need to learn this? Praise God. As I said, if we know more about Jesus, if we know more Jesus, we will love him more. We will adore him more. We will value him more. We will praise him more. We will worship him more. Isn't it? So it is good to know everything that is to be known about Jesus. Isn't it? Praise God. What does Paul says? Paul says, my desire is so that I may know him. So that I may know him. He was a genius of the Torah. He was a genius of Pentateuch. He was genius of Talmud, isn't it? Still he says, my purpose is to know him. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I pray that your purpose and my purpose is the same as what Paul says, that we may know him. Hallelujah, praise God. Then he says three things, but I'm not going to go there. My focus is right now greater than temple. Jesus in tabernacle. Thank you, Jesus. Second thing I want to say, we all know how tabernacle looked at, isn't it? You guys are, if you are part of it, we talked about Old Testament quite a bit. Let me not call it the Old Testament, not so New Testament, isn't it?
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. The temple layout was very peculiar, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. See, God gave Jonah a commandment to build an ark. And that commandment was given around more than 4,000, 5,000 years ago. They're still trying to figure out how to build that ark with all the technology and everything. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. But when God got the commandment, the ark did not sink. You see that memes going all over the place. Titanic sank, but ark didn't sink. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Why? Because it was given by God. It was commanded by God. It was ordained by God. And it was planned by God. When God plans something, hallelujah, praise God, we better pay attention to it. So God has planned this tabernacle, hallelujah. And in the tabernacle, there were a few parts of the tabernacle. There was a one part called outer court, and then an inner court, and the Holy of Holies. And even in those parts, there were some furnitures were there, hallelujah, praise God. And you, I know that you all know that. If you don't know that, hallelujah, know it right now, praise God. From Exodus, book of Exodus. In the outer court, there were two particular things, which was the altar of offering. And a brazen laver where you could wash the hands. When you enter the holy place, there are three things there. Hallelujah, praise God. There is a lampstand, which is a candle stand, whatever you call it. Then there is a table of showbread. Hallelujah, praise God. And in between, there is an incense altar. Hallelujah. And when you enter Holy of Holies, there is only one thing, which is an Ark of Covenant. Hallelujah, praise God. How does it look when you have a bird's eye view of tabernacle? How does it look? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. When you see inside the tabernacle, if you open the roof, and how would it look? This is how would it look. What does it point to? It points to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. And we're going to go through a few amazing things. You may consider this a Bible study, you may consider a sermon, you may consider preaching, whatever you may consider, but that's fine. We want to know how Jesus was given in temple, how Jesus was revealed in the tabernacle. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's open Exodus chapter 25, verse number 9. Exodus 25, verse number 9. Hallelujah. God said to Moses, I will show you, and you make the tabernacle according to what I have not told you, not written to you, but according to what I have shown to you. Hallelujah. Praise God. And God does not say this one time. God says this 5 to 6 times in book of Exodus and book of Leviticus to confirm that okay, tabernacle no engineer Musa no to. Architect was not Aaron, isn't it? Aaron was building something different. We're not going to go there, isn't it? Hallelujah. It was plan and purpose of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Exodus 25:40 says the same thing. Exodus 26:30, Exodus 27:8, Numbers 8:4, all says the same thing. That Moses, you make something, make a tabernacle, which I showed you. Hallelujah. The question comes, and I always say with the question, when did God show it to him? Because Bible doesn't write about it. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. And now that is the difference between, hallelujah, how we read our Bible. If we read it as a textbook, we say, evidence are missing. If we read as a word of God, we would say, that is a revelation. Hallelujah. That on particular day, when Moses on Mount Sinai, we do not know what he did for 40 days and 40 nights, but God showed him temple, and that is how he's supposed to build it. How did God show the temple? Which temple God showed him? There was no temple on the earth whatsoever. So what did God show to him? God showed him a heavenly temple. God showed him a heavenly throne. And based on that design, the tabernacle was built. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me open one verse for you. Hebrews chapter 8, verse number 5. Hebrews 8, 5. And this will be the spine of the series that we're going to go through. Akashmani vastuni pratima che. We know what pratima is. It's a copy or a foreshadow of the things in heaven, isn't it? Hebrews 8:5. Yes, please go ahead, Chrissy.
Jem Musa ne jare te mandap ubo karvano hato, tyare dev taraf thi suchna mali hati, તેમ કેમ કે તેણે કહ્યું કે જો જે નમૂનો પહાડ પર તને દેખાડવામાં આવ્યો હતો
Isn't it? So the tabernacle was plan of God. Tabernacle was idea of God. Tabernacle was design of God. And I want you to pay attention right now. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Moses did not say that, God, I want to see you and meet you. Where can we meet? Aaron did not came with the idea, Prabhu, apne yaar madiye dos. Just heard from our elders, heard from our forefathers, we should meet up. It was God's idea. It was God's plan that God wanted to meet the mankind. God wanted to reveal himself to mankind. God wanted to come and dwell with mankind. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it is always God's plan. And through Jesus, that plan was fulfilled. Amen. God did not remain like a by and by pie in the sky kind of a guy, isn't it? God did not remain an unseen force, so to say, isn't it? A lot of people quote it like that. God did not remain an abstract concept, but God came to dwell with the human race. Hallelujah, praise God. It was God's plan that after mankind was separated from God due to our sin, God says, you know, I'm going to go see them. I'm going to go meet them. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And even now, that's what God wants. God wants to commune with us. God wants to have fellowship with us. હું અને તમે ઈચ્છા રાખે ને એના કરતાં પ્રભુ વધારે ઈચ્છા રાખે કે આપણે એની જોડે સમય વિતાવીએ. ઇઝ રાઈટ? પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. એન્ડ ગોડ હેઝ એક્સપ્રેસ દેટ મલ્ટીપલ ટાઈમ્સ બુક ઓફ રેવલેશન, ઇઝ રાઈટ? એન્ડ વી ઓલ નો દેટ વર્સ. ઇટ ઇઝ રિટન સો મેની પ્લેસીસ. ઇટ વી હેવ સીન દેટ મેની પ્લેસીસ. રેવલેશન ચેપ્ટર 3 વર્સ નંબર 20. એન્ડ જીસસ સેઝ, બિહોલ્ડ આઈ સ્ટેન્ડ એટ ધ ડોર. હાલેલુયા, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. એન્ડ નોકિંગ, ઇફ એનીવન હિયર્સ માય વોઇસ એન્ડ ઓપન્સ ધ ડોર, આઈ વિલ કમ ઇન એન્ડ ઈટ વિથ હિમ. And he will be with me. Why does God want that? God, I am here. I don't have to worry about anything. I don't have to deal with your mess. Isn't it? I am in my glory. Angels are serving me. Hallelujah. But think it this way. God wants to have fellowship with you. God wants to have communion with you. God wants to have relationship with you and me. Hallelujah. Why not we open our hearts, mind for him? Why don't we set aside a time for him to have that communion and have that fellowship? Hallelujah. When we open our hearts, Father, hallelujah. Bible says, let the King of glory come in. Bhagalo matha uchki shake, isn't it? Hallelujah. You and I have to open our hearts to let the King of glory come in. Praise God. Hallelujah. One more thing I want to say before I go. Thank you, Jesus, for a few things. Hallelujah. In the tabernacle, the glory of God was veiled. It was veiled. But in Jesus Christ, the glory of God was unveiled. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's open one more verse before I go there. Tabernacle is the foreshadow of the things to come. Galatians chapter 2, verse 16 and 17. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Those are the things. Those are the foreshadow of the things. But the substance is Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Whatever happened before is just symbolic. Yes, it was a real part of the history. But the real substance is Lord Jesus Christ. NLT translation says this way. For this rules only applies only shadow of the reality of yet to come. And Christ himself is the reality. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. When God designed tabernacle, hallelujah, it was one person in mind, and that was Lord Jesus Christ. Let's go to Exodus chapter 25. Exodus 25. Verse number 1 and verse number 2. God says, Moses, we're going to build a tabernacle. You're going to coordinate the tabernacle process. I'm going to direct you how to do. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. And Hebrews just taught us that Old Testament was a foreshadow of the things to come. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. Old covenant gives us the shadow. The new covenant gives us the substance. Hallelujah. People of Israel walked in the shadow of things. Hallelujah. You and I walk in the substance of things. That is Lord Jesus Christ. Just be with me. Just think about if we did not have revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. We say that Israel is easier. Israel is very difficult to walk in the presence of God because Jesus was not given. It was just under shadow. It was just under so many prophecies. It was just very a little bit complicated process. Hallelujah. But for you and me, we have received the revelation of Lord Jesus Christ. And we walk in that light. We walk into that revelation. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus, because substance belongs to Lord Jesus Christ. Verse number 3. Isn't it? Three kind of metal. God is going to say, what are you going to collect? You're going to collect gold, you're going to collect silver, and you're going to collect bronze. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm telling you, everything points to Jesus. Even the metals that are used to build the tabernacle points to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. When you say gold, gold means gold is something very pure and something very precious. Hallelujah. Praise God. That talks about the deity of Lord Jesus Christ. That Jesus is God. He's unblemished. He's sinless. Hallelujah. He's perfect and he's the most precious God. Gold points to that. Silver. Hallelujah. Let's open one more verse. Exodus chapter 30. Don't open it. There are 4 or 5 verses. I have many grounds to cover. Exodus chapter 30. Israelites were asked to bring particular offering into the presence of God once a year. It was silver half shekel. Everybody has to bring it once a year. Prabhu nu vachan ke je dhanwan hoy ane ana karta vadhare appu nahi an je garib hoy ana karta ochu appu nahi karan ke e dan papartar panne arthe ganay. It was a hallelujah, praise God. It was a offering for atonement. Wherever silver is there, it is considered an atonement offering. Hallelujah. The temple was built of silver. So every time you see silver, you see an atonement. Atonement. Atonement for Lord Jesus Christ. And the third thing, it says bronze. Pitarni vastulavi, isn't it? Praise God. Let's open one verse. Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse number 23. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It Akash kevu thai jase? If you read the context is the judgment of upcoming judgment is coming, isn't it? Bronze always talks about judgment, isn't it? Hallelujah. If you see the statue of statue that Daniel saw, there is a bronze feet there. It also talks about judgment there. Hallelujah. Praise God. Whenever you see a bronze in the temple, you will see Jesus as the coming judge. He's going to come to judge the living and the dead. We all will stand before the presence of God, before the throne of God, and God will judge righteously. Te aankhe joya pramane ke kaane sambhadya pramane insaf karshe nahi. But he will judge according to his living word. Praise God. Hallelujah. Even the metals points to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. So I hope I'm not boring you. Praise God. Let's read verse number 4. Verse number 4. And? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. God says, you're going to bring specific colors. Purple bhi chahiye andar, isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Good that God told Moses, isn't it? Sipurana ki to ke prabhu kayo shade blue no, isn't it? I'm not going to go there. Hallelujah. For man, there is only one blue. Praise God. Okay, come back. Come back to blue. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. God says use the blue color. Yeah. When you look, go outside, when you look up, what is the color of the sky? Blue color, according to Bible, makes us understand that the source is heavenly. Hallelujah. It is from heaven, isn't it? It is the highest one. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Before Jesus became Son of God, hallelujah, or Son of Man, as he came into the earth, he always existed in the heavenlies. Praise God. Thank you. Second color that is used is? Purple. Purple. Isn't it? We are not doing without any reason here, isn't it? Praise God. The purple is the color of the king. It's a royal color. If you remember when Jesus was being crucified, before crucifixion, he was mocked. He was brutal. He was flogged. And Bible says they brought him a robe of purple. Because kings wore such robe. They were mocking it. But I want to tell you, Jesus is the King of the King and the Lord of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. The purpose of this purple color, we want to declare even without saying that Jesus is the King of this church as well. Amen. Amen. And not only this church, he is also a coming king. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So even purple color points to the kingship of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to challenge you. Hallelujah. A lot of time we make him a savior. Have we made him a king? We made him a savior. Have we made him a Lord? Isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. Let the kingship of Lord Jesus Christ rule your heart and my heart. Rule our desires, our house, our prayers, our plans, our purpose. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The third color that is mentioned is scarlet. Gujarati answer lagi? Kiramji. What does the red color signify? The blood of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. It points, hallelujah, praise God, the atonement of Lord Jesus Christ. It points toward the suffering servant that Jesus became. It points towards the ultimate price that he's paid, hallelujah, through his sinless blood. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. And the fourth thing it means, Sharna Vastra. Isn't it? What does it say? Fine linen. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you study the book of Revelation with me, the linen represent the righteousness. પ્રભુનું વચન એમ કહે કે જ્યારે સંતો પ્રભુની હજુરમાં ઉભેલા છે ત્યારે તેમણે ચોખ્ખા સફેદ શણના વસ્ત્ર પહેરેલા છે. ઇટ ઇઝ અ રાઇચિયસનેસ. હાલેલુયા. પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. હાલેલુયા. વેન બાઇબલ ટીચિસ ધ ટેબરનેકલ હેઝ ટુ બી અ ફાઇન લિનન, ઇટ સેઝ હાલેલુયા, જીસસ ઇઝ ધ પરફેક્ટ રાઇચિયસ વન. Jesus is the sinless one. He is the perfect one. There is nothing can be added to him. Hallelujah. Praise God. Be with me. Be with me for 1 minute before I move ahead. Thank you, Jesus. Blue. Heavenly. Hallelujah. Son of God. Purple. Jesus is the King. Scarlet. Jesus is the Savior. Fourth. Linen. Jesus is the righteous one, Son of Man. Hallelujah. Praise God. The perfect man. Be with me. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. When John writes a gospel, John does not give a genealogy according to Matthew and Luke. John gives a different genealogy. A genealogy says, Jesus is the Son of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. When Matthew writes it, Matthew writes the genealogy from kingly perspective. Hallelujah. And Matthew declares that Jesus is the King. Hallelujah. Praise God. When Luke comes, Luke always talks about the suffering. Hallelujah. Praise God. And he portrays the crucifixion in great detail. Hallelujah. Luke portrayed that Jesus is the Savior. Hallelujah. And when Mark comes, hallelujah, Mark. Hallelujah. He portrays Jesus as the Son of Man. Hallelujah. Praise God. All the four colors display the great gospel. All the four gospels displays all four distinct characteristics of Lord Jesus Christ. The scholars debate a lot of time. The gospels are contradictory, but they are stupid enough not to understand that every gospel is a revelation of different aspect of God. Hallelujah. When we read Matthew, hallelujah, he said, he's my king. Hallelujah. When we come to John, he said, he's the Son of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Few more things. Goat's hair. Bakrana? Vaad. Isn't it? Praise God. What does a goat represent? Isn't it? Goat represents a sin offering. Isn't it? On the Day of Atonement, there were two goats taken. Bible says specifically two goats were taken. It talks about the sin offering. Azazel, if you remember that study, hallelujah. It represents to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The ram skins dyed red. Red, right? Lal karela. Rangela chamda. Isn't it? Praise God. It says consecrations. Badger skin. Seal machli lakhi hai, isn't it? Badger skin. The badger skin is not very pleasant to look at. It's very rough. It's not pleasantly looking. That's how Prabhu ke maybe koi vastu ye sari na dekha di ane tabernacle ma add karwan ki tu. Hallelujah. Prabhu nu vachan Isaiah chapter 53 ma kya chai, isn't it? Hallelujah. Ke when we saw him, apne ne kyo joyo? Tena ma koi સૌંદર્ય ન હતું. લાવણ્ય વગરનો હતો, ઇસને, અને આપણે એને હતાશ થયેલો, દેવથી માર પામેલો પામ્યો. હાલેલુયા, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. ધ બેડજર સ્કિન ટોક્સ અબાઉટ ધ સફરિંગ ઓફ લોર્ડ જીસસ ક્રાઇસ્ટ. હાલેલુયા, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. એન્ડ એન્ડ સમ ઓફ ધ બાઇબલ સેઝ અકેશિયા વુડ, બટ સમ ઓફ ધ બાઇબલ સેઝ શિટીમ વુડ. ઇફ યુ ઓકે જેવી વર્ષન સેઝ શિટીમ વુડ. હાલેલુયા. They have studied the shittim wood and they have found the shittim wood or the acacia wood that was 4,000-5,000 years old, and nothing has gone bad with the wood. No termite has come, no corruption has come, a fug na lagi gaye wood ma. Whenever the wood is mentioned, shittim wood is mentioned, acacia wood is mentioned, it talks about the incorruptibleness of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. His flesh was even uncorruptible. Hallelujah. પ્રભુનું વચન એમ કે સામ 16 વર્સ નંબર 10. લેટ્સ ઓપન ઇટ. સામ 16:10. આપણને લાગે કે દાઉદ પોતાના માટે લખી રહ્યો છે, પણ ડેવિડ ઓલસો હઝ અ પ્રોફેટ. હાલેલુયા. સામ 16:10. કેમ કે તું મારો આત્મા શેઓલને સોંપશે નહીં, અને તારા ભક્તને કબરમાં જવા દેશે નહીં. ઇઝ ઇટ માય યુ વિલ નોટ અલાઉ માય ફ્લેશ ટુ ડીકે. ઇઝ ઇટ હાલેલુયા. ડેવિડ ડાઈડ, કબરમાં ગયો. Isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. It is about Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. His body was uncorruptible. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. What I want to tell you is everything and everything is pointing to Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Verse number 6. Praise God. What does the oil represent? What does oil represent? The Holy Spirit, the anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. There are not many Jesus Christ in the world. There could be a lot of people. I have a lot of Spanish people. I know their name is Jesus. But none of them are Jesus Christ. Because the word Christ means the anointed one. Anointed one. Hallelujah. When Jesus stood in the tabernacle, or sorry, synagogue, and when he preached his first sermon, he opened the book of Isaiah and he says, hallelujah, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me and God has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He is the anointed one. Hallelujah. Praise God. And also it can also indicate that through him and through him alone, we can receive Lord the Holy Spirit as well. Hallelujah. Pachi oil pa isu lavanu chhe? સુવાસિત ધૂપને સારું સુગંધિયો. ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ? પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. ફ્રેગરન્સ. હાલેલુયા. ફ્રેગરન્સ પોઈન્ટ ટુ ધ ફ્રેગરન્સ ઓફ લોર્ડ જીસસ ક્રાઇસ્ટ. હાલેલુયા. પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. થેન્ક યુ. ઇઝ ધ રેસ ઓફ શેરન. હી ઇઝ સો ફ્રેગરન્ટ. હાલેલુયા. હિઝ લાઈફ વોઝ ફ્રેગરન્ટ. ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ? પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. વેર એવર હી વેન્ટ, હાલેલુયા, હી સ્પ્રેડ દેટ ફ્રેગરન્સ. હાલેલુયા. પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. ધ લવ ઓફ જીસસ વોઝ રિવીલ્ડ થ્રુ હિમ. હાલેલુયા. ધ લાઈફ ઓફ ગોડ વોઝ manifested through the life of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He is the most fragrant one. He lived a beautiful life. Verse number 7. ગોમેદ પાષાણો ને એફોદ તથા ઉરપત્ર ને માટે જડવાના પાષાણો. જાળવાના પાષાણો. પાષાણ is a very very colloquial word, but my Bible says precious stone. Hallelujah. See, those stones are very precious. અને જેટલા સ્ટોન્સ મેન્શન થાય આમાંથી અમુક સ્ટોન્સ અત્યારે આપણને અવેલેબલ પણ નથી. દેટ પ્રેશિયસ આર ધેર. સમટાઈમ્સ વન પર્સન ફાઇન્ડ્સ અ વન ડાયમંડ, રેરેસ્ટ ઓફ ધ ડાયમંડ, ઇટ ગોઝ ઇન ઓક્શન, સેલ્સ ફોર બિલિયન્સ એન્ડ બિલિયન્સ. હાલેલુયા. પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. ધેન વેન એવર ઓનિક સ્ટોન્સ આર પ્રેઝન્ટેડ ઇન ધ સેન્ચ્યુરી, ઇટ શોઝ એન્ડ ઇટ ડિરેક્ટ્સ ટુ ધ પ્રેશિયસનેસ ઓફ લોર્ડ જીસસ ક્રાઇસ્ટ. હાલેલુયા. પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. હી ઇઝ મોસ્ટ પ્રેશિયસ વન. એન્ડ you can hear so many testimonies about people. I was reading a Christianity Today magazine and it was talking about the persecution in China. And the persecution you can't even describe, because like when you describe, you feel that feeling. And even during that persecution, they are not willing to leave Lord Jesus Christ. They're not willing to put away their faith. At the point of death, at the point of the death of their loved ones, and a brutal reality of mankind, what can ever do. They are not willing to leave Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because they know how precious he is. How precious he is. Hallelujah, praise God. See, a lot of time what happens? When we receive that preciousness so easily, we don't value it. You see? Prabhu nu vachan ki tamara motiyo ne? Bundo ni aganda na ko. Why? Bun does not have value of that moti. Because what does bun does? He eats feces. He eats garbage. And any value nothing, isn't it? Praise God. I want to encourage you. No matter how long you've been walking with Lord Jesus Christ, he's still precious. he still has the highest value. Hallelujah. He is irrepressible. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Ravi Zacharias quote this passage from a Scottish theologian, James Stewart. And I'm going to read that passage. I love this passage. And he has quoted in multiple sermons. And I love it so much. And he talks about who is Jesus. It says, he was the meekest and lowliest of all sons of man. Yet spoke of the coming in the clouds of heaven with the glory of God. He was so austere that evil spirits and demons cried out in terror at his coming. Yet he was so genial and winsome and approachable that children loved to play with him. And little one nestled in his arms. His presence at the innocent gaiety of village wedding was like a presence of sunshine. No one was half compassionate to sinners, yet no one spoke such red-hot scorching words about sin. A bruised reed he will not break. His whole life was love. Yet on the occasion, he demanded of the Pharisee how they ever expected to escape the damnation of hell. He was the dreamer of the dream and the seer of the vision. Yet for the sheer stark realization, he has all of the stark realists soundly beaten. He was servant of all. Washing the disciples' feet, yet masterfully strode in temple. And hucksters and money changers fall over one another to get away from the mad rush and fire they saw blazing in Jesus' eyes. He saved others, yet in last he did not save himself. There is nothing in history like the union of contracts which confronts us in the gospel. The mystery of Jesus is the mystery of divine personality. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And I think this word do a somewhat justice to what Jesus is. Hallelujah. Praise God. But I want to tell you, though, your whole lifetime for you and me is not enough to learn what Jesus is or who Jesus is. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. One more thing. A couple of things I'm going to share. Hallelujah. Before I move ahead. Praise God. Thank you. As we are talking about tabernacle. We talked about the metals and the wood and everything. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's talk about the entrance of the tabernacle. You can see the tabernacle on the TV up there, right? Hallelujah. It's not a great picture. Is there another one? Shelley, if you can show that one, which I sent it to you. Thank you, Jesus. Something like that, isn't it? So if you see a bird's eye view, it is all around the curtains. And then when you enter there, there's an altar and a lever and then the tent itself, which is a holy place and the holy of holies place. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. There was an entrance to the tabernacle, and I want to talk about it. Praise God. I want to talk about two things. Hallelujah. Praise God. Out of all the tribes that sat around the tabernacle, the entrance was at a particular place. And the entrance was where the tribe of Judah camped. Where the tribe of Judah camped. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It was a prophetic thing that Jesus would be born in the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah, praise God. Bible is called that Jesus is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Judah means praise. Hallelujah. Judah led Israelites into the conquest. Wherever they went ahead, the first tribe to go ahead was the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to tell you something. Praise God. Wherever you go, hallelujah. Wherever you walk, hallelujah. There's someone goes ahead of you. Hallelujah. And that is, hallelujah, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Praise God. I'm not just telling you to excite you, hallelujah, but Bible teaches me in Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse number 8. Let's open that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Deuteronomy 31, 8. Punaniyam ekatris ane aat. Mm-hmm. Praise God. You know, hapki jo velasu. We have small kids in the house, right? Have you seen them? We know what the hapki jo, isn't it? Right? Like something like that. He said, "Don't do that. There is no need for that, because I am walking ahead of you. I am walking ahead of you, and I want to do just think it over it." Right? That God is himself walking before you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We know not to be afraid of anything that God has asked us to do because God is walking ahead of you. We need not to worry about, hallelujah, okay, how I will be able to success in my call with God because God is walking ahead of you. Hallelujah. We don't have to worry about if God has brought me to Canada, will I be settled down? Before even you came to Canada, God has walked ahead of you. Amen. Praise God. Every Sunday, me and Mrunal pray while we sit in the car. I say, God, you go before us and fill that sanctuary with your holy presence. Because he promised that he goes ahead of you and ahead of me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. When we are walking where God wants us to walk, I want to tell you, Jesus is walking before you. Hallelujah. When we are walking through the valley, Jesus is going before you. Lord, I say, God, I don't see you. Yeah, you don't see because he has gone before you. To prepare a place for you. To make every valley, Bible, every valley should be lifted up and every mountain should be brought down in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He goes before you. Hallelujah. When mountains are on your way, hallelujah, I want to tell you, Jesus is going before you. Let's open Isaiah chapter 45, verse number 2. Okay, stay right there. Timba tekra bahu nani vastu chhe yaar. Isn't it? Timba tekra, so we can even climb. I don't need God for that. Isn't it? What does English translation say? Isaiah 45:2.
I will go before you and make the crooked places straight.
Crooked places straight. Another translation.
I will go before you and will level the mountain.
Will level the mountain. Not timba tekra. Timba nani vastu chhe. The mountain, what I'm going to do? I'm not going to make a way out of the mountain. I'm not going to make a tunnel out of the mountain for you. So small dost now, bahar din nikli jao. What I'm going to do, I'm going to remove the mountain out of your way completely. Amen. As if it is never there. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. See, Lord of the Lord, Prabhu, nani favor. See, no, nani favor. Yeah. Then ask somebody else. Don't come to me. Isn't it? I don't do nani favor. Isn't it? Praise God. He says, I'm going to remove completely mountain. See, if God wanted, be with me. It's a very simple thing. If God wanted, God could escape the entire Israelites in the middle of the night. He didn't do that. Isn't it? Hallelujah. If God can put Adam in divine anesthesia, if God can put Abraham in divine anesthesia, he can pull whole city of Egypt, country of Egypt in divine anesthesia. Israelite would walk up, but he didn't do that. He says, what I'm going to do? They will see and you will walk. They will see that you're going to walk and I'm going to go before you. Prabhunu vachanam na kecha. Isn't it? I want to encourage you. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. As Judah walks before the whole tribe, God is walking before you and he's going to level every mountain in your way and my way. Amen. Praise God. Receive it by faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because faith is the currency that works in the kingdom of God, and that is how we receive everything. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. He's not going to bore a tunnel. He's going to remove the mountain. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So I'm talking about the gate after the going inside the tabernacle. The gate is coming from the tribe of Judah, which is Lord Jesus Christ. If you want to enter the presence of God, you to go through the tribe of Judah. You to go through Lord Jesus Christ only. Amen. Praise God. In tabernacle, there were three gates. Okay, be with me. First gate, you're completely outside the tent. Completely outside the tent. First gate, you're now in the tent. And now you're in the outer court. Right? Now there's a second gate. Now from the outer court, you're in the inner court, which is a holy place. And there's a third gate. It's from the holy place to Holy of Holies. Three gates, isn't it? Praise God. Hebrew scholars believe that there were names of these gates. The names were given of these gates. The first gate that you could enter in the outer court is called the way. Everybody say the way.
The way.
It was called the way. Hallelujah. When you go through way, you can come in the outer court. Hallelujah. But now there's a second gate there. That gate is called the life. When you cross that gate, you come into the holy place. And the last gate that makes you enter in Holy of Holies, it used to be called the truth gate. Hallelujah. Then when you cross through that, you can come into the Holy of Holies. When Jesus spoke onto that occasion, and when Jesus says, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, it was very offensive to Jewish people. He said, how can you say that we have to go through you to go to the temple? But he was perfectly right without Jesus. Jesus says, you know, what is the second part of that verse? He's saying exactly same thing. He says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Unless you go through me, you will never come into the Holy of Holies. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That is the second part about that gate. And let me tell you, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. The outer court gate never closes. It always remains open. Hallelujah. It is up to you and me to walk into it. We can walk into it. It never closes. Hallelujah. Praise God. God's gift, hallelujah, of coming to Lord Jesus Christ is open for everybody. He does not make hurdles there. He has kept it wide open that you can walk into it and receive him the way he has promised you and me. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Thank you. John chapter 14, verse 6, which I quoted, Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to Father except through me. Thank you, Jesus. This was the introduction. Now we're going to go. But I'm going to talk about only one thing today, then we will talk about it next time. Hallelujah. Praise God. The first thing when you go into the outer court, the first thing that anybody will ever see is the altar of sacrifice. Altar of? Sacrifice. If you see, if you're coming from there where the smoke is shown, that's the first thing. You will see the pulpit and the cross here, isn't it? The first thing you will ever see. Hallelujah. The first thing that you ever see when you enter the outer court is, hallelujah, praise God, is the altar of sacrifice. Let's open Exodus chapter 27. 27, verse number 1 and 2. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. You make an altar, and God gives a commandment how to make an altar. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Be with me. Be with me. If you want to go to see God, you have to go into the Holy of Holies. But before you could ever go into the Holy of Holies, you have to come across the altar of sacrifice. Unless you handle the altar of sacrifice, you can't go forward. Hallelujah. Praise God. The altar was a place of sacrifice. Until a sacrifice is given, then there is an opportunity to go inside in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, no matter what your background is, what your experience is, what your theological understanding, I want to make a statement. Unless we have received Jesus, we will never able to experience the presence of God fully. Never. Never. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because even to go into the Holy of Holies, you have to go through the altar of sacrifice. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know, Jesus also made an altar. Hallelujah. But it was not on the temple. It was on the hill of Golgotha. This was the altar. Isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. He made an altar. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Prabhu nu vachan em kahe ki tyan su banai char singh banai. Isn't it? Char singh banai. Horn like projection on the four corners. You know why was it used? To tie the sacrifice. Isn't it? Sacrifice would not knock a bakro ke chalo. Aaj apne. It's not going to do that. Isn't it? It's going to move, it's going to jump, it's going to babble, it's going to do everything. It will tie it to the altar. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus went onto that altar willingly. One author said very well, it was not nails on hands and feet that held Jesus there. It was your love and my love that kept Jesus there. Amen. Hallelujah, praise God. That is the perfect altar. And without that, we can never imagine getting into the presence of God. Amen. Praise God. When Jesus says, let's open John 15, verse number 13. John 15, 13. Koinonati. No greater love than this. No greater love. That we are using love. We are almost abusing the word love here, isn't it? Right? Left eye, right center. Isn't it? Pandar Dios, my love. Yes.
Okay. Sure.
Why not? Isn't it? When Jesus says there is no greater love, it means there's a measure of love. Isn't it? We don't have love meter to measure how much love is less or more, isn't it? But love is always expressed through a action. Isn't it? You can say I love you all the time. Isn't it? Isn't it? There's no meaning of it. Love is expressed through an action, isn't it? And Jesus says the greatest love is no man than this, than to lay down. He says, If you want to express your love at the highest level, hallelujah, that love would require you to sacrifice your life for your friends. Hallelujah. And Jesus expressed that, isn't it? By dying on the cross for you and me. That is what the altar of sacrifice looks like. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Bible says, kitya horns of the singular kyu? Singular kyu. Singular jo projection hai, char baju. Hallelujah. Altar is not also a place of sacrifice, it is also a place of refuge. Let me say it again. Altar is not only a place of sacrifice, it is also a place of refuge. Daud ne bohuda bala koda. Isn't it? Hallelujah. But there was prophetic anointing only upon one man and one man alone, that was King Solomon. David has many people, and King Solomon was not the eldest king, eldest son. He had a couple of sons who was elder than him, isn't it? Praise God. He also had other son who wanted to be the king, but God says Solomon is going to be king. And out of that, one of the sons was called Adonijah. Adonijah, you know, Daud no dikro hato, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And asu karyu, balwo karyu. Raja Amganis. Isn't it? See, history doesn't change. It's always the fight for the chair. It was there. It's now. It's going to continue. Isn't it? Hallelujah. But let me tell you, Bible in the book of Revelation shows only one chair. Throne of God. Isn't it? There's only one person sitting there. Isn't it? So no need to worry and fight about it. Isn't it? Let's come back to Adonijah. Adonijah says, I'm going to be king. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Solomon did not fight many wars, but Solomon's a very smart guy. He did not keep any enemies alive. Isn't it? Kaane enemy ne mitro banaya, kaane enemy ne, isn't it? So Adonijah ek mara raja banu chato, evo to nahi chale, isn't it? So Solomon says the Adonijah must die. Okay, let's open 1 Kings chapter 1. Hallelujah, thank you Jesus. Chapter 50, sorry, verse number 50 diyo achon chalu kariye. 1 Kings chapter 1. First King 1, chapter 50, 50, or sorry, verse 50.
550. But Adonijah, in fear of Solomon, went and took hold of the horns of the altar. Then Solomon was told, Adonijah is afraid of King Solomon and is clinging to the horns of the altar. He says, let King Solomon swear to me today that he will not put his servant to death with this word. Solomon replied, if he shows himself to be worthy, not a hair of his head will fall on the ground. But if evil is found inside him, he will die. Then King Solomon sent men and they brought him down from the altar. Then Adonijah came and bowed down to the King Solomon. And Solomon said, go to your home.
Go to your home. You find mercy because you hold the horns of altar. Isn't it? Praise God. Jesus has died on the altar. All you and I have to do is to grab the horn of that altar. Amen. Hallelujah. To trust and say that my sacrifice is there. That is the sacrifice that has paid my price. That is the sacrifice that has paid my penalty. I am no longer under penalty. God grant me mercy. And God grants mercy based on the other sacrifice that is placed onto the altar. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. One more thing. As I made an application out of this, be with me. I'm going to close very soon. I mean it very soon. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Altar is a place of refuge. It is also a place of sacrifice. But altar is also a place of death. It's a place of death. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. As I said, can we show that again? The whole tabernacle. We will not be able to experience the presence of God or the power of God until death. Until something dies. Isn't it? Praise God. If you want to experience the presence of God, if you want to experience the power of God, death must take place in your life and my life. Death to flesh. Without it, we will not see the power of God. Death to self. Death to ungodly desires. Desires are not bad because the Bible says he will give you desires of your heart. But the desires which are fulfilled outside the plan and purpose of God, death to those desires. Death to pride. Death to sinful lifestyle. Death to me first. Death to me, myself, and I. Completely. Hallelujah. Praise God. When death takes place, then you enter the presence of God. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. three verses I'm going to quickly quote. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Luke chapter 9, verse number 24. Let's open that verse. Luke 9. Bachavse, isn't it? The death must take place. Hallelujah, praise God. Jesus also said, hallelujah, if you want to follow after me, praise God, then you must carry your
cross.
Whose cross? Own cross. Hallelujah. And follow after me. Deny yourself. We talk about the cost of discipleship, isn't it? Deny yourself and follow after me. Praise God. We must have to die. Our self has to die. Our pride has to die. Our ungodly desire has to die. Our sinful lifestyle has to die. Praise God. And I'm telling you as a caution, word of caution. Hallelujah. Praise God. A lot of time we take a little longer to leave the things behind. Right? We receive Lord Jesus Christ. We are born again. And Bible declares you righteous, even though you're not righteous completely yet. You're righteous, made righteous by declaration that you're righteous. Praise God. Now, we don't have to live those sinful lifestyle to become a righteous. We have to live the sinful lifestyle because we are righteous. Isn't it? We are declared righteous. And a lot of time, we don't experience the presence of God, the power of God. Our walk is tall. Every 6 months, we are backsliding. The reason is the self has not died yet completely. It has to die. Isn't it? When self dies, a lot of things dies along with it, isn't it? I just give you a list. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. But the self dies. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's see one more thing. Galatians chapter 5, verse number 24. Jeho Krishna che. Okay, be with me. I want to see the people who are of the Christ. Jeho Krishna che. Tene pota sharirne tena vishayo tatha ichhao suddha. Vadastame jadinido che. Is it? Praise God. If you want to experience the fullness of life, you must die. Because through your life, you will never experience fullness. When you die, then the fullness of Jesus comes in and dwell in you. Praise God. Hallelujah. We must have to die. Hallelujah, praise God, to our own self. One more verse, and I'm going to close. Thank you, Jesus. Galatians Madhuri, 2:20, which is Paul's declaration, and I pray this is all of our declaration.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Hallelujah. If you want to see the power of God in your life, you want to see the power of Jesus dwelling in your life, Prabhu nu vachan Paul ange, I have been crucified with Christ and I no longer live. But the Christ who dwells in me lives. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The altar represents sacrifice. It represents Lord Jesus Christ, his sacrifice. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Pastor Nikki used to say that salvation is free. Free to us, not to him. It cost him ultimate thing, isn't it? But after that, everything has a cost. Discipleship has a cost. And the cost is you yourself. Me, myself. Hallelujah. Praise God. One last thing I'm going to close. And I want you to think it through this very carefully. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Whenever the sacrifice was given, right? When Elijah gave a sacrifice unto Mount Carmel, when Solomon gave sacrifice unto the new temple, hallelujah. The moment sacrifice took place, something miraculous took place. What happened? The fire from heaven came. The fire from heaven did not come. Je geta bagra charta tha ena par na aayu. Je geta bagra altar par na tha ena par par na aayu. Je geta bagra no balidan appa ma aayu tu. Those who have died, upon them the fire came. Amen. Praise God. If you want the fire of God, you and I must die. If you want the anointing of God, you and I must die. Then the anointing comes. Then the fire of God comes. Amen. Praise God. The fire does not come on the resisting one. The fire comes on the submissive one. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, we talked about Lord Jesus Christ, but I want to encourage you. I want to think about it. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. That every area that we are rebelling, resisting, we are not submissive to Lord Jesus Christ. Every sin, temptation that we fall under, every sinful lifestyle we mull over, every pet sin, and I'm calling it a pet sin. Pet sin means we take it out whenever we need it, we play with it, then we let it go. Every pet sin that we harbor, we need to let it go. Then we will experience the power and anointing of God. And be with me. One more thing I want to say there. Pastor, I still feel anointing. Great, great. Hallelujah. But you have not felt the greater anointing which comes with the sinless lifestyle. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Anointing. Saul, when walked, Paul then walked, people will lie down in the shadow of Paul. And they will get healed. What an anointing. Isn't it? They would take the handkerchief, they would take the apron that Paul ever touched. When they touch it, they will receive the healing. Greater anointing. Hallelujah. Praise God. Prabhu Vachana, Jesus Christ says, when you follow me, when you become my disciple, you will do greater things than what I have done. Isn't it? We will do greater things. Hallelujah. But for that, we have to die to ourselves. Hallelujah. On that altar, Jesus has already died. But I want to die. I want yourself and myself to go through that death on the cross with Lord Jesus Christ so that we will experience the power of God. We will experience the presence of God. We will experience the anointing of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And you know what? The most difficult person to go on the cross is myself. We can crucify everybody else. Right? Myself. So I want to challenge you and encourage you. Hallelujah. Praise God. As we talk about more Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. What is the purpose of knowing about Jesus or knowing Jesus more? So that we can become like him. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's bow down our heads. We're going to go into the communion. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. I'll request Vikas Bhai and Pastor Peter to help me in the communion. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Would you please come over, Pastor Ji? Vikas Bhai. Thank you, Jesus. As the brother bring communion, let us prepare our heart and mind. Lord, we want to say thank you, want to praise you, want to worship you, Father God. As we look at the tabernacle, Lord, we want to say thank you that Jesus, you have made a way for us, oh my Lord. It was impossible for us who are not from Jewish background, we want to enter the outer court, Father God. But Jesus has made that way for us so we can enter that. Hallelujah, praise God. We want to say thank you, Father God, that Jesus became the atonement for us. Jesus became the sacrifice for us. Jesus became so precious for us, Father God. And you paid the highest price, Father God, so that we can grab that horn of altar and we will not undergo that punishment. We can grab that horn of altar and we will not die. We will not go corruption. We will not go under judgment, Father God, because Jesus has been crucified under the cross, Father God. We want to say thank you for that. Lord, if you have not acknowledged your presence, acknowledge your preciousness, acknowledge your fragrance, acknowledge your sacrifice, Lord, we want to say we're sorry for that. Hallelujah. We understand, Father God, how amazing you are, how precious you are, Father God. We love you, we worship you, we exalt you, Father God. And Lord, we also pray right now, Lord, as Apostle Paul prayed, Father God. We want to live a life, hallelujah, a crucified life, submissive life, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we put ourselves onto the cross along with you, Father God, so that, Lord, we die and you live through us. The life that is in Christ Jesus be manifested through us, Father God. Hallelujah, is my prayer right now, Lord. Our pride, our anger, our resistance, our sinfulness, Father God. Our wrong thought process, Father God. Hallelujah. Let it all die, oh my Lord. And let us become completely new is my prayer. Thank you, Jesus. I'll request Pastor Peter to pray for the communion. And then we'll worship the Lord and partake in communion.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, for dying on the cross for us. For shedding your blood for us. Lord, without your ultimate sacrifice, we won't even be here, Lord. So, Lord, as I take these emblems, I lift them up to your throne.
Yes, Lord.
Just ask, Father God, I thank you for the blood that you shed for us.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I thank you, Father God, for your body, the lashes you took on your back for us, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
So as we partake this, Father God, I ask that you touch your people.
Yes, Lord.
I thank you, Father God. Whoever needs healing, heal them, Father God, in the name of Jesus as they partake. Lord. And Father God, I thank you that you cleanse them from their every sin, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
And you purify them. And Lord, I thank you from this day forward, as they take the communion, Father God, open the floodgates of heaven for them, Father God. And pour out your blessings on them.
Yes, Lord.
I pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Brothers will stay here. Please come over, worshiping the Lord. Stay back to your place. Spend time in prayer. We'll take communion together. Thank you, Jesus. Let's come. Come over. God.